Hi, my name is Jörg Pirs, and I'm one of the co-authors of the AppCoins white paper. The AppCoins protocol for app stores has three use cases, and today I'll share with you a more detailed approach to the mobile advertising use case. Mobile advertising is a complex space with several resource draining flows between the dozens of parties involved, which can potentially lead to high fraud risk. How does AppCoins proposes to solve this issue? In a nutshell, we will do so by simplifying the whole process and directly connecting developers, app stores and users, so that AppCoins becomes the language they can openly speak. We propose the elimination of almost all of the intermediaries and now the transactions done in a transparent and secure way through the blockchain. We also propose a way to assure that users actually converted campaigns and there's no too little fraud risk. There are three moments in the AppCoins protocol: campaign creation, impressions and attribution. The first moment is the creation of campaigns, which is done by developers directly with app stores. In this case, developers can set several campaign filters, like geolocation and other apps installed, as well as campaign parameters, like how many AppCoins they want to spend in the campaign, how much is paid by each attribution and the campaign's duration. The second moment is showing impressions to users. We'll do so by matching app stores to their users with active campaigns, and then show the available campaigns for each user. These two first moments, campaign creation and impressions, already eliminate all the unnecessary intermediaries that exist today. The third moment is when users convert the impression shown to them. Whenever users give 2 minutes of attention to a certain app in campaigns, they get attributions and are entitled to their share of AppCoins. 2 minutes of attention is the action defined in the protocol for conversions. How do we make sure users actually give 2 minutes of attention to apps? To make sure of this, the protocol implements a proof of attention algorithm, which is a cryptographic proof that is public and verifiable by anyone, including the developer. For this, we consider information taken from the user's devices, like if the app was running, if the device was unlocked, and if the screen was on during that time period. We also consider public information from users, such as their wallet addresses and past transactions, as well as their network fingerprint. From this, we compute the proof stating that the user gave, in fact, attention to an app. Regarding transactions occurring on all of these steps, there are some important requirements that we need to meet. First, there's a need to ensure that the developer doesn't run out of funds during the campaign. Then, there's also the need to make sure that there are funds available for each impression shown to users. Besides that, transactions need to be fast, scalable, and cheap, since we project that there will be a significant amount of transactions from advertising. For this, the protocol implements a system based on a mix of on-chain and off-chain transactions occurring in a two-level captivation scheme, which is composed by a number of captivation wallets with the purpose of locking funds for a certain period of time. So, when a developer creates a campaign, the campaign funds are sent from the developer's wallet to a campaign wallet, which is a first-level captivation scheme. This is meant to make sure that the developer doesn't run out of funds before the amount of AppCoins that was set during the creation of the campaign is exhausted. These type of transactions from developers' wallets to campaign wallets are done on-chain. When impressions are shown to users, the corresponding values of the attributions are sent to impression wallets, which are second-level captivation wallets. These transactions are meant to make sure app stores don't show impressions to X users when there are AppCoins available in the campaign for only Y users, where Y is less than X. The AppCoins in impression wallets stay there for a small period of time, so if a user doesn't convert the impression during that period, those AppCoins are sent back to the corresponding campaign wallet. When there's a conversion, the AppCoins for that conversion are sent to wallets of the user, the App Store, and the OEM in the predefined proportion, which is 85% for the user, 10% for the App Store and 5% for the OEM. This way, the protocol implements scalable microtransactions with very small fees, making this an efficient way for developers to monetize their apps. And that's it for today. Stay tuned for the next video on the in-app building use case. Should you have any questions, please leave a comment below or refer to the more detailed article on Medium.